Welcome and study with Tanzania Institute of Education. Hello, pupils. Welcome to the Standard 7 English language class. I'm your English teacher. How are you today? Our lesson today is listening and language practice. Fine, I would like you to prepare a pen and an exercise book or a writing pad. All right, I hope now we are all ready to start our lesson. Then sit down and listen attentively. Before we start, I will read the tongue twisters. A black cat sat on a mat and ate a fat rat. Then read the tongue twisters after me. A black cat sat on a mat and ate a fat rat. Again, a black cat sat on a mat and ate a fat rat. Good. Now answer the following questions. Do you know cats? Yes. Why do people keep cats? People keep cats for catching rats and aspets. Why do people keep cats? People keep cats for catching rats and aspets. Do you know rats? Yes. Why do you think rats are afraid of cats? Rats are afraid of cats because they eat them.
Hello, pupils. Let us go for a short break.
Let's study, be educated. Elimu ni kazi. Elimu ni kazi. Learn, let's study, be educated. Elimu ni kazi.
After a short break, let us proceed with our lesson.
Listen carefully to the following story and write down points. I will ask you some questions after reading. At first, I will read slowly, then I will reread it in an increased speed. Tutu, the cat, was hungry, and he said to himself,
I will go into the bushes to look for food.
On the way, he saw a rat coming towards his direction. He started to chase the rat. The rat ran across the path while Tutu ran after it. The rat saw the tunnel, then passed through it and ran away. Since Tutu was too big to pass through the tunnel, he walked past the tunnel and went back home. So now I'm going to tell the same story, but a little bit quick. Tutu the cat was hungry and said to himself,
I will go into the bushes to look for food.
On the way, he saw a rat coming towards his direction. He started to chase the rat. The rat ran across the path while Tutu ran after it. The rat saw the tunnel, then passed through it and ran away. Since Tutu was too big to pass through the tunnel, he walked past the tunnel and went back home. Now, answer the following questions. Question 1. Suggest the title of the story. Again, suggest the title of the story. Question 2. What was the cat looking for? Again, what was the cat looking for? Question 3. What ran across the path? Again, what ran across the path? Question 4. Did the cat pass through the tunnel? Again, did the cat pass through the tunnel?
Hello, pupils. Let us go for a short break.
Let's study, be educated, elimu ni kazi. Elimu ni kazi. Learn, let's study, be educated, elimu ni kazi.
After a short break, let us proceed with our lesson.
Now, let us check our answers for the questions from the story I have read earlier. answer for question 1. The title of the story maybe could be Tutu the Cat, or we can say The Cat and the Rat. Oh, Tutu the Cat and the Rat. Again, I can say the title of the story maybe could be Tutu the Cat, or The Cat and the Rat. Oh, Tutu the Cat and the Rat. Answer for question 2. The cat was looking for food. Again, the cat was looking for food. Answer for question 3. The rat ran across the path. Again, the rat ran across the path. Answer for question 4. The cat didn't pass through the tunnel because he was too big to pass through it. Again, the cat didn't pass through the tunnel because he was too big to pass through it. I hope you have checked your answers. So let us congratulate ourselves and have a big applause.
After a short break, let us proceed with our lesson.
Hello, pupils. Let us check the following exercise. Did you hear the following words in the story? Again, did you hear the following words in the story? Into, towards, across, through, and past. Again, into, towards, across, through, and past. The words that I've mentioned show movement. The words that show movement are called prepositions of movement. Prepositions of movement are words which shows movement from one direction to another. Now, let's see how prepositions of movement are used in sentences. I will go into the bushes to look for food. The word into shows the movement to inside something. It can be a place, a container, or an area. Again, I will go into the bushes to look for food. The word into shows movement to inside of something. It can be a place, a container, or an area. He saw the rat coming towards his direction. The word towards means in the direction of something. Again, he saw the rat coming towards his direction. The word towards means in the direction of something. The cat ran across the path. The word across shows movement from one direction of a path to another. Again, the cat ran across the path. The word across shows a movement from one direction of a path to another. The rat passed through the tunnel. The word through is used to show movement from one end or side of something to the other. Again, the rat passed through the tunnel. The word through is used to show movement from one end or side of something to the other. He walked past the tunnel and went back home. The word past means at the far side of something. Again, he walked past the tunnel and went back home. The word past means at the far side of something.
Hello, pupils. Let us go for a short break.
Let's study, be educated.
After a short break, let us proceed with our lesson.
Hello, pupils. Let us check the following exercise. Now, construct two sentences for each of the following words. Those words are into, towards, across, through, and past. I repeat again. Into, towards, across, through, and past. Here are examples. Example number one. The tea he poured into the cup was cold. Again. The tea he poured into the cup was cold. Example number two. She entered into the bedroom and slept. Again. She entered into the bedroom and slept. Example number three. She walked towards the shop. Again. She walked towards the shop. Example number four. A baby was toddling happily towards her mother. Again. A baby was toddling happily towards her mother. Example number five. She swam across the river. Again, she swam across the river. Example number six. Our school is just across the road. Again, our school is just across the road. Example number seven. He walked carefully through the forest. Again, he walked carefully through the forest. Example number eight. The bird entered the house through the window. Again, the bird entered the house through the window. Example number nine. There we are jogging past the city mall. Again, there we are jogging past the city mall. Example number 10. He drove past our school. Again, he drove past our school. Hello, pupils. Let us check the following exercise. Apart from these prepositions of movement, do you know any other prepositions of movement? Example of other prepositions of movements. Now, pupil, use your dictionary to find the meaning of the following prepositions of movement and construct two sentences for each. Those prepositions are onto, away from, out of. Again, onto, away from, out of. Now, pupil, use your dictionary to find meanings of the following prepositions of movement and construct two sentences for each. Before we are done with our lesson, take this exercise. I would like you to practice with your friend to use these words in different situations.
It is our hope that you have enjoyed our lesson from our teacher. Until next time, bye!
Let's study, be educated, elimuni kazi. Elimuni kazi. Learn, let's study, be educated, elimuni kazi.